in this video we will see unit 4. Okay, system design using confusion unit 4. Generally this is on clocks, clock and razor circuit. Because any digital circuit has clock and razor circuit. Okay, how these clock and razors are handled in FPGA, we have to know. Okay, so this is the matter from textbook KC Chow. So what are the topics that you have is, what is clock buffer, clock tree, how we generate this clock tree generations, and how this reset circuit will be there, and what you mean by clock skews and fixes. Okay, so these two will see afterwards, synchronous between what you mean by synchronous between clock domains, clock divided, gated clocks. Okay, so what is clock and result in FPGA? We know that FPGA has many blocks, okay, like this. In flip flops, many will be placed. So each should get its reset and clock. Okay, so how it comes? So this is main reset. Okay, say X flow. From this buffer will be there. So this buffer again is given to 4 paths. Okay, then this is going to some other, again it is divided, and again this through this buffer it is coming to this flip flop. Okay, because this some one more flip flop is there, it will go to that flip flop. Like that many will be, all will be connected. Okay, so this is how the distribution is there, reset distribution to all the circuits. It has to give to all the flip flops or counters or register. So this is how it is. This is called the tree of reset. Okay, similarly this should contain clock. So clock also will come like this. So clock, main clock is there, the from that buffer they are given to the again subdivision buffers, clock distribution. This is available, then each will come to, so you see, for this flip flop, this clock. Similarly from here to this. Okay, so this is C, reset one, this is given reset second one. Okay, so this is how these clocks and resets are divided in the FPGA. This is called trees. Okay, so suppose reset is this. Okay, main reset, sorry, this reset. But when it comes to RST0, okay, this is your RST0. Okay, so some delay is there. So this is called the reset tree delays. So much delay is there to come to this point. Okay, then RST1, so much delay. Okay, from here to here, this is your main one, reset. Sorry, so this delay is called the skew, reset skew. From the main reset to this is called the skew, because this is here. It will take some time now to come to this. So how much delay it is taking after getting this is called the skew. This is reset. Similarly for clock also. So this is your main clock. Okay. So to come to this clock, it will take some time. So that is also delay. So this is reset value delay. About the clock and reset circuits, how it will be there in the FPGA network. Okay, so generally we know that what is clock and good one, because in FPGA we implement big designs. Okay, so they require multiple clocks, multiple data paths will be there. Okay, for all that you have to do the reset and clock. Okay, so we have to focus mainly on how much clock rates are there, what is the skew rate, how much maximum clock we can run in the design without any error. That is called the main thing in the release. Okay, clock tree and clock buffer. So what do you mean by clock tree and clock? So this is your main clock source. Okay, from there this is subdivided, level 0, level 1, like this. This is called the clock tree. Okay, so how it is given to all? So from the main block to so many levels it has crossed, and you get the clocks here. The same thing I showed here, no? So see here, like this, four. This is called the clock tree, and these are called the buffers, clock buffers. Same thing, we can insert here buffers also, and same thing, okay, buffer. Here already buffers are there, buffers session also you can see. Okay. Next in this, one more is, what is Q? Just now I told, because these two flip flops are there. Okay. So this is getting clock one through this buffer, after this buffer it is come. And this is also going to legs to this clock, but here one more buffer is there and it is coming to this. Okay. Because it's like a tree, so this is getting at one delay. It is so clock one is coming here, means clock two obviously will come little bit late. So the difference in this is called the clock skew. Okay, so some buffers generally will be added for delay. Okay, so this is called the clock skew difference between the clock, how much it is allowed. So this is about the clock skew. Okay. So some in this. Next we have some definitions. Okay. Generally, what are the general definitions in this clock tree? What is clock tree? What is clock buff? What is clock skew? What is hold time? What is setup time? Propagation delay. Okay. These are basic terms in the clock timings. Okay. So this we'll see in the next. I told this today in this video, clock tree, clock buff, clock skew. We'll see hold, setup time and propagation delay in the next video. So this is about the clock skew. So if the exam, what do you mean by clock skew is, you can draw this figure, explain this. Similarly, what are we mean by clock, either this or this diagram. You can explain what do you mean by clock and reset circuits. Okay. So, how it is generated means, you have to write programs, okay, program for this, for how we generate in the system, okay. So, this topic, that is clock we generate, how we see same thing, this is a structure, but how generally they write in the program, okay. So, we will see this clock divider, this in the next video, okay. Thank you. Please like, do share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Thank you for